So far, we're 3 days into the NHL playoffs, and in today's video, we're going to be recapping what's transpired in each of the NHL playoff series thus far. And that's coming up next. Hey everyone, and welcome back to another video here at Top Shelf Hockey. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by. We review and discuss all 31 NHL teams, so if you're a huge hockey fan, consider subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. So as I mentioned off the top, today we're going to recap what's transpired in the NHL playoffs so far. We've had 3 days of game action. Every series has played at least one game. Some series have two games in now, and there's been all kinds of interesting things transpire here in these series so far. So we're going to do a quick recap of where each series is at and what I project seeing happen here going forward. Let's get started here with the Winnipeg Jets and the Minnesota Wild in the Western Conference. This has been a series I've watched quite closely so far and has been incredibly entertaining. So far in the first two games, the Jets are now up 2-0. The first game was kind of pretty close. The Jets started off a little hesitant, picked things up as the game went through, and then we've seen them have a small lead going into the third period, and then Minnesota took over, scored a couple of quick ones and put the Jets game in jeopardy. The building was really quiet. That sea of white, the atmosphere in the Winnipeg Arena has been incredible. And then we saw the Jets afterwards kind of bounce back. They ended up taking that game. Patrick Laine kind of took over that a stretch of a third period of time there and got his team back in it. And then they rebounded late to pull ahead and take the victory. Now the second game was a lot more lopsided in my opinion. The Jets were a lot more dominant. We're starting to really see Dustin Byfuglien slowly take things over. He's delivered a number of big hits to the Wild. You can certainly tell they're really missing Ryan Suter in the back end. And the Jets ended up pulling away with a 4-1 victory in that game, in game two, to pull up 2-0 and take care of home ice. Obviously, I fully suspect Minnesota to play better at home. They have a very solid home record, and they have a very good atmosphere, and their crowd will be behind them 100% when they get back home for game three. So I do expect a better result here for the Wild in game three. Hard to say if they can really step up and get a game from the Jets. I did expect this series to go a little bit longer and closer than it's been so far, but we'll see how things go. Maybe the Wild can take care of home ice and make things a little bit closer and a little bit more interesting. But if things keep going the way they have, right now the Jets are well on pace to dominating this series. So Minnesota needs to stop the bleeding here and get some stuff going on home ice. Now, speaking of being up 2-0, we'll stay here in the Western Conference. The Vegas Golden Knights pull it off again. A big double overtime victory. They're now up 2-0 on the LA Kings. The LA Kings have barely been able to put a puck in the net so far. They were shut out in the first game. This game, they only managed one goal. Obviously, the Drew Doughty suspension, which we talked about here the other day, played a fairly big role on the Kings being without their, clearly their best defenseman, arguably their best player, and one of the best, if not the best defenseman in the NHL. It certainly has a big, big impact on your club. Although, considering they were without Doughty, they did drop the game, but it certainly wasn't a blow by any means. It was a very close game. Vegas pulls it out in double overtime. This Vegas team is just proving all the doubters wrong. Even myself in my playoff previews, I said that it was going to be a close series, but I thought the Kings' experience might be too much for Vegas. But man, every time you can't bet against Vegas. They keep proving everybody wrong, and good on them. They've had a heck of a storied season so far. And at this rate, really, I fully suspect that they will probably win this series now. And at this rate, you just can't bet against Vegas. Like, I just, they keep finding a way. What an incredible story. Good on them to keep going here. Obviously, like I said, the Kings have a ton more experience. They've been close games, mind you. And if things change back in LA playing in the Staples Center, maybe things will, change a little bit when they change the scenery here to the LA Kings Barn. But at this rate, it's really hard to bet against Vegas. They've been keeping it close. They've been getting good defense, good goaltending, and they're finding a way to get it done. So they're up 2-0 as well. Now, the other two series in the Western Conference have one game in. We saw the Nashville Predators handle the Colorado Avalanche pretty handily in game one. As I predicted in my prediction videos, leading up to the playoffs getting started here, I said the Predators should handle the Avalanche pretty handily. And even though the Avalanche got off to a pretty good start in game one, the Predators came back and kind of took over and ended up with a 5-2 victory. They play game two today, so I fully suspect more of the same. I think Colorado's going to have a big mountain to climb here to get make any traction here against the Predators. So we'll see as they play game two. Not as much to report there where they've only got one game in, but kind of going as planned and as predicted in that one. The other Western Conference series, we have the Anaheim Ducks and the San Jose Sharks. Now in my prediction video, I did predict the Sharks to win. So far, they did win game one. They shut out the Ducks by a 3-0 score, which is also in Anaheim having home ice at the Honda Center there. So that was a little surprising in a way that it went so handily as it did, shutting out the Ducks. I didn't expect that. We'll see. I fully suspect the Ducks to rebound here in game two. They just have too much experience on that on their side, to kind of not make this a little bit closer, a little bit more interesting. So I fully suspect the Ducks to rebound and have a much better game here in game two. But so far, we've got the Sharks up 1-0. Not a huge surprise, but it's only one game in. So we'll see how things go. But if the Sharks can steal another one here, heading back to home ice, then that's not looking good at all for the Ducks. Now moving over to the Eastern Conference, we've got some very interesting series over there as well. Let's jump into the one we kind of call the yin and yang series. It's the Penguins and the Flyers. They got two games in. They split the first two in Pittsburgh. We saw a pretty wide margin of score for both teams, which is kind of, we'll see how things settle down here as the series goes on. We saw the Pittsburgh Penguins absolutely blow out the Flyers in game one, and then the Flyers come back with the big 5-1 victory in game two. So they've taken their turns kind of blowing the other team out of the water here, on the scoreboard at least. Now in the last game, the Flyers, they have a 5-1 victory, but they were badly outshot. They actually got some pretty good goaltending for a change, but they really needed it in that game as well. But we'll see how things go in this series. I really don't think the Flyers can beat the Penguins myself. I predict the Penguins to win. I think overall, the Flyers, as much as they do have a pretty good offensive team, their forward group, I don't think their defense and goaltending are good enough, but we'll see. I mean, you never know. You can have good flashes of superiority here in this series, and they showed that in game two. They handled the Penguins pretty good. Now they're heading back to home ice with a split. So if I'm the Flyers, I'm pretty content leaving Pittsburgh with a 1-1 series split heading home. So if they can take care of home ice, maybe they'll stand more of a fighting chance than people are giving them here. Obviously, they need to continue to get good goaltending out of Brian Elliott. Obviously, he's going to be the key for the Flyers, and their defensemen really need to step up in a big way. I know it's a big task. The Penguins have a lot of big top-name forwards that are really potent offensively, and they're hard to handle. But that's really, that is going to boil down to them. I mean, I have a lot of confidence in the Flyers' offense to put some pucks in the net. But if they can't keep the puck out of theirs, then they're going to be in big trouble, and special teams as well is going to play a big role moving forward. So we'll see how this series shifts to Philadelphia. Obviously, like I said, we saw both teams kind of blow the other one out. So I'm not sure which version we're going to get of that in game three. But let's jump over here to the Tampa Bay Lightning taking on the New Jersey Devils. They played game two of that early today. So right now, Tampa handled the Devils fairly good in game one. We saw the Tampa Bay Lightning rebound, obviously heading down the stretch the last probably 8-10 games of the season. They really weren't quite that good. You could argue even the second half, they weren't nearly as dominant as the first half as well. So obviously they did come up with a 5-2 victory in game one. So overall, pretty solid effort by the Tampa Bay Lightning. They did get Stamkos back in the lineup, which was a big help as well. So obviously, a lot of people fully suspect the Lightning to win here. And I did predict the Lightning to win as well. But, the New Jersey Devils is another team, kind of like Vegas. I've had a really hard time betting against this year because every time I bet against them, they burned it. They burned me on betting against them. They always seem to prove me wrong. On paper, if you look at them, they have a lot of good young players. And sometimes you think that the experience will overwhelm them, and it really hasn't. They've kind of stuck with that all year. They've had a tremendous season, and they've had some good goaltending down the stretch for Keith Kincaid. So we'll see what happens here. Obviously, if Tampa comes up 2-0 on this series, I think it's going to be a pretty big hole for the Devils to claw themselves out of. So game two goes today. We'll see if the Devils can rebound and even this series up. Another series which has game two go today as well as the Washington Capitals against the Columbus Blue Jackets. This one looked as though the Capitals had full control early on. Obviously, the Blue Jackets end up taking a major penalty. Josh Anderson get a 5-minute major penalty and removed from the game. So the Capitals got a 5-minute power play, and they scored two quick goals from Kuznetsov. Things looked to be well under control, but they stuck with it. The Blue Jackets kept hammering it home, kept bringing it back, and they ended up tying things up, sending it to overtime with a big overtime victory. I thought Seth Jones was tremendous for the Blue Jackets. He was an absolute beast back there on D, really leading this team by example with hard work, logged a lot of minutes, Was very good on the offense as well. Like, he just really had an all-around tremendous game. He really is an underrated defenseman. Doesn't get enough love when it comes to talking about the Norris Trophy and being one of the more elite defensemen in the league. He's certainly worked his way up that list over the last number of years since he's been in the NHL. Because I think it's could be just because of where he plays, maybe. But Seth Jones just doesn't get enough recognition, I don't think, for just how solid of a defenseman that he's become. So we'll see if the Blue Jackets can hold things up here as they play Game 2 in Washington. See if they can't steal a couple heading home to Nationwide and see how they can do it back at their own barn. I fully suspect the Capitals to kind of get their stuff together here. They are going to come back with Philip Grubauer in Game 2, which does not surprise me at all. Grubauer's been the better goalie all season, and as much as you could... That first game, you really can't blame Grubauer. I mean, yes, they lost. Maybe he could have been a little bit better. But overall, he wasn't bad by any means. You can't pin this loss on him. So I'm not surprised they're coming back with him. If they do go down 2-0, Columbus pulls another one out, though, I think that they need to do something. And even if it's not on Grubauer, one of the few options they have is to change their goalie, kind of shake the team up here. And I think we'll see Holtby in Game 3 if Game 2 doesn't go to plan. So I'll be very curious to see if Ovechkin and company can get their act together and get this series tied up in Game 2. Now, moving on to the final series that we haven't discussed yet, the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Boston Bruins. This was a very entertaining first game. I can't wait to watch Game 2 this evening to see how this goes. This has the potential to be a very nasty, hard-hitting, physical, in-your-face kind of series. I wouldn't suspect anything else. Obviously, the Leafs are going to be without their number two center, Nazem Kadri. Kadri plays an absolutely huge role for the Leafs, and it really is going to hurt their lineup without Kadri in there. Obviously, in case you missed what happened, we did a video on him being suspended for 3 games as well. There'll be a link up here in the YouTube card as well as the end screen if you want to go back and watch that video. Basically, there's no footage of the actual hit, which we can't show here because of copyright rules, but we had a discussion on what happened, what transpired, and what my thoughts on that situation were. Basically, in a nutshell, he went overboard, took a run at Boston forward Tommy Wingles, and he got ejected from the game and he got a 3-game suspension. Wingles probably should have been called for a penalty on that play, and if they had blown the whistle quickly for an elbow being called, you know what, maybe that doesn't happen. Maybe that could be a series-changing event right there. Obviously, Kadri out for the Leafs is huge. They could have potentially got a power play out of it. Hard to say how the game would have went if there would have been a referee right there to call that elbow that he delivered on Marner, and maybe Kadri didn't come racing across the ice to do that. It's really hard to say. I mean, obviously the referees can impact the game one way or another. Obviously this was, possibly you could say it was a missed call, but you know, it is what it is. And regardless of the fact Kadri shouldn't have reacted the way he did, I understand he was defending his teammate, which I will fully support, but I think he went over a little bit too overboard and got himself in trouble, and now it's put his team in a bad predicament. So hopefully the Leafs can bounce back here and make this series a little bit more interesting. The Bruins did hand them a 5-1 defeat in Game 1. Special teams were huge. Bruins' power play was clicking on all cylinders. They can keep that up. Even Marchand, he walked that line with being an agitator, but he didn't cross it. He was getting Leo Komarov's face, giving him some kisses there. If you didn't see that, that's a clip you want to go find as well. Check it out. Obviously, Komarov was trying to get under Marchand's skin, and Marchand is really, he's not a guy you want to do that to, because he's going to get under yours and win that battle just about every time. He was getting right up in his face and giving him kisses, trying to say, if you're going to get up right up in my face, and we're going to be intimate about it and make you uncomfortable. And I think he certainly served his purpose and got his point across. So it was certainly fun to watch. I think it's going to be probably one of the more entertaining series in this playoffs to watch. I did predict in my prediction video as well to watch this series closely. It's going to be very entertaining, and I did predict the Bruins to win. I said it's probably going to go 7 games, so we'll see. I would like to see it go 7 games just for the pure entertainment value. Obviously, I think that both teams have a real heat on for each other. It's only 1 game, but you could tell it's getting chippy enough that I wouldn't suspect Game 2 is going to lighten up any. Obviously, they've got a little bit of a history here with the playoff series a few years back. Even though both teams have kind of changed a fair bit of the personnel on the ice, that heat still exists and is not going anywhere. So stay tuned for Boston and Toronto. If you're new to the channel, I hope you consider subscribing. We cover all 31 NHL teams. There's plenty of content here for everybody to enjoy. If you haven't done so already, consider following us on Twitter. You're going to find our Twitter handle on the screen right here. A couple of quick reminders here before we go. We have a 1,000 subscriber giveaway coming right up. Obviously, we're not too far away from that. So as soon as we hit that, we're going to be giving away a brand new NHL Adidas hat. So stay tuned for that giveaway. So if you're new to the channel, subscribe so you can be part of that as well. As always, thank you very much for watching, everybody. We'll catch you next time.